Hey, Dan, I'm always learning about random topics and researching whatever I feel interested in at the time. For example, a week ago, it was the Norman conquest of England, then it was medieval calligraphy, and today, communism versus socialism. I'd like to think that I'm retaining at least some of the information I learned, but it seems that when a topic I just read about comes up in conversation, I can't remember the information when I try to retrieve it from my brain. It's like the information is right there and I know it, but I'm not able to grasp it. Any advice from Hannah? You kids use computers so much, you start getting confused and you think that you are a computer. Hannah, let me just say, your brain is not a hard drive. This is the inside of a hard drive. This is the inside of a brain. See, they're different on the inside. Regurgitating facts is kind of just like a neat little party trick at this point. It's cool if you can do it, but if you can't, no big deal, because like Google is a thing.
Why am I even in school in the first place then, Dan?
As you learn new things, those new things change who you are as a person. Maybe everything that you read about medieval calligraphy will have vacated your mind within 6 months. However, studying calligraphy maybe gave you new respect for handwritten word or something like that. This is Roger Ailes. He is the worst kind of human being in that he started and runs Fox News.
Terrorist fist jab?
Santa just is white.
Say you're a cocaine dealer. And you kind of look like one a little bit.
I am currently listening to an audiobook about his life, a biography. I'm not going to remember all of the specific details, you know, where he went to college, who he married, who he divorced, who he married, who he divorced, who he married. But being that he's an accomplished media head and I am a young person working in the media space, I'm learning lessons from his life story that I am immediately applying to my own way of being. For example, I learned about Roger Ailes' obsession with every segment having a payoff. There should be something at the end of every segment in any form of media that, you know, it makes it feel to the viewer as though, oh, that was really worth me staying until the very end. Last video, it was, what, Kate Upton at the end, and then before that, there was a staring contest. Basically, Hannah, you have absolutely nothing to worry about. In full disclosure, I don't think you were ever worried in the first place. Let's revisit your email real quick. Hey, Dan, I've always learning about things, always. I want to email you and ask how I can learn even more because all the other students just spend all day playing Flappy Bird and Snapchatting each other pictures of their genitalia from Hannah. That's a little bit of a humble brag.
Being famous is cool and stuff, but it's also like sometimes it's like, ugh.
I should really stop making fun of people who send me emails. People might not send me as many emails. I'm really sorry. I shouldn't have done that. This is getting really close on my face. What is wrong with Dan Brown? Is this a strong enough payoff? I hope so.